Students, today let us embark on the journey of accumulating writing skills, and this is Art of Writing Part 2. In the first one we had seen how to use approximates and intensifiers, and in this lecture we will see how to use alliterations, similes and metaphors. Now without these our writing would not be interesting. Therefore, we need to accumulate all these skills to embellish our writing. That means to make it beautiful. Alliterations is the repeated use of the first letter or sound of a word to call attention to what we have written. Therefore, we know that for anything to be interesting, you need a good start. In the same way, you need a good ending as well. For example, in your descriptions, in your narratives, and it is used a lot in poetry and in tongue twisters. Now, how do they help us, or how do they get our attention? Let us see the first example. That Monday morning was misty and mysterious. See the M's. Now, if we write so many M's in a single sentence, definitely the reader will be forced to focus his attention on our writing. Now, it was a delicious end to a delightful day. See how beautifully you're saying, you're comparing it to something delicious, that your day was delicious, something like a delicious end to a delightful day. So it makes our writing really good and beautiful. See the last one. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Automatically, one becomes all ears if you hear a sentence like this. So this is how we use them, and we need to get the skill of writing or expressing ourselves in this way. So the first thing, approximates. Whenever you are talking about anything or writing about anything, wherever possible, use approximates. Number two, intensifiers. Don't say this is just, it was mysterious. You should say it was extremely mysterious, it was really mysterious, or it was really extremely misty and mysterious. So you see, automatically anybody who reads will pay attention to what you are writing. Yes? Now, see this. It is such a beautiful use of bitter, biting, bittern, bit and better. So just with five of these rhyming words, they have made such a beautiful tongue twister. Try and practice, and you can also try and make some of your own. So let us see this. Now, to understand this, you need to know, we know what bitter is, bitter gourd. Yes, it tastes bitter. Biting, we all know what biting is. Bittern is a small bird. Yes, so it's a small bird. Now let us try and understand with the explanation that I have given you what exactly this means. A bitter biting bittern bit a better biting bittern, and the better biting bittern bit the bitter biting bittern back. Said the bitter biting bittern to the better biting bittern, I'm a bitter biting bittern bitten back. Yes, try and understand and try and speak or say it. Next. A certain young fellow named B.B. wished to marry a lady named Phoebe. But he said, I must see what the minister's fee be. Before Phoebe, be Phoebe, B.B. Yes? I thought a thought, but the thought I thought wasn't the thought I thought I thought. If the thought I thought I thought had been the thought I wouldn't have thought so much. Or if I would want to change it, the last one I could change. If the thought I thought had been the thought I wouldn't have thought the thought. Correct? Instead of writing so much, you could say the thought. I wouldn't have thought of that thought. The doctoring doctor doctors the doctor the way the doctoring doctor wants to doctor the doctor. Not the way the doctor wants to be doctored. Yes? Now, let us see this. Skyscraper, muck, manure from farm animals, muck raking. Yes, why we have this, or why are we seeing this? Let us see the next slide. and then we can come back to this. All right? Now, similes. Now, what is a simile? A simile is a form of figurative language. So, students, a simile is a form of figurative language in which a comparison is made between two things which have something in common. And in this, we use the words like or as. So, if we are describing anything, instead of simply writing in a simple way that she is a girl or she is fond of fighting or there are two friends and they fight with each other, instead of saying like this, the first simile or what you can write is they fight like cat and mouse. Okay? Now, if a person is brave, then you can say that he is as brave as a lion. So these similes we need to learn, and for various situations you should learn and keep a number of similes and use them at the time of writing. The next one, I am as busy as a bee. So you see, the first one was like, and this is as brave as busy as, and number four is she is as happy as a clam. Now, what is a clam? On your right, you have the pictures of oysters and shells. Yes? So, at the bottom, you have that is a very, very happy clam. If you see the cartoons, they are like this. And that is why we have this simile. She is as happy as a clam. Shell. Seashells. All right? My grandmother is as blind as a bat. Instead of saying she's blind and she can't see a thing, you can say that she is as blind as a bat, as light as a feather. This child is as light as a feather. That means you can say underweight, very, very skinny, doesn't weigh at all. So you can say as light as a feather, as bold as brass, as fresh as a daisy. That means you are comparing the freshness of the thing to flowers. All right? Her attitude is as cool as a cucumber. The whole family is as common as muck. Now, what is muck? That is the slide that you had seen earlier. This is muck on your right. Muck is dirt, and usually it is manure from farm animals. So you can spread muck on fields. But if you have messed up with your exam, you didn't do your exam properly, you can say, I mucked up my exam. If you went out on the field and you have dirty hands and boots, you can say, my hands are mucky, please don't touch the table. Or, your hands are mucky, don't touch that thing. Yes? Please beware, stay away from me, my hands are mucky. All right? And then if you make dirty jokes, then you can say, please stop these murky jokes with me. Mucky jokes. All right? So muck, mucky. So you see how you can use this word? Now there's another word that you need to know is muckraking. Now that means an activity of looking for information about people's private life that they don't wish to make public. So that is muckraking. All right. So these are good words that you can use in your writing. All right. Let us come back to our slide, our similes. So down we have, my cousin is as tall as a skyscraper. Now it is just not a building, a high building that reaches almost the sky. That is how we have this word. Scraping means almost touching. So the skyscraper means very, very tall. So instead of saying that the person is very tall, you can say that the person is as tall as a skyscraper. See how you can get other people's attention if you use similes in your writing? Yes? So all the similes that you use in your day-to-day life, you need to learn them and make a collection of them. I was so scared that I was as white as a sheet. You can also say, I was so scared that I was as white as if I had seen a ghost. Yes, my daughter is as sweet as sugar. Now in literature, see how we can use it. See the song. In the song, it's my life. Yes, we can see an example of simile in the line, my life is like an open highway. I've been working like a dog. Now this is from A Hard Day's Night, written by the Beatles. All right, you are as cold as ice. So this is how we use similes. All right, now let us see again a comparison. A simile compares two things and we need to use as or like in our sentences. She could swim like a fish. He was as brave as a lion. Now when you say he was as brave as a lion, it gives you a vivid memory or a picture in your mind of a lion. Now see the lion below. Yes, so the picture of a lion comes to your mind. And what does it do? Similes describe or they paint a very clear picture in your mind. So vividly means clearly. Now if you need to describe a stubborn person, then you could say he was as stubborn as a mule, M-U-L-E. Yes? Now can you see two people? They are trying to pull the mule, but the mule doesn't budge. What is budge? Move. All right, and what is the picture that comes to your mind? The picture that comes to your mind for a person could be on your right, body of a person but head of a mule. So that means he is as stubborn as a mule. Now he felt, supposing somebody is drowning, you can say he felt his body was as heavy as lead. He felt as if his body was heavy and he was going to soon sink. She was as mad as a hornet. Hornet is a wasp. Yes, so that is why if you try to hit or disturb a hornet, it moves, or a wasp, it goes in various directions, you know. So you can say she was as mad as a hornet. All right, now some more similes that you need to learn. As cold as ice, as strong as an ox, as snug as a bug in a rug. That means the person doesn't move. Very lazy, not exactly lazy, but very comfortable. Just like a bug would be in a rug. Yes, a carpet. As fierce as a volcano. We all know volcano, how fierce it is when the lava comes out. So you can say as fiery as a volcano. Yes, you can use it even for the fiery things you eat, spicy. So you can say that this dish is so fiery. All right, it is as fiery as a volcano, as light as feather, as crooked as a witch's hat, as busy as a bee, as bright as the moon, as sly as a fox, as bold as brass, as good as gold, as slippery as an eel, as blind as a bat, as smooth as silk, as old as the hills. So you can say she is as old as the hills, ancient as the hills, as tough as nails, as clear as mud. That means dirty, murky, all right? That you cannot see properly in water because there is mud. As wise as an owl, has eyes like a hawk, sleeps like a baby, fits like a glove. Yes, worked like a charm, magical, that the person wouldn't agree, but as soon as that person says anything, just the person being there, worked like a charm, magical, slept like a log. We have the picture of a log. Yes, so when you are oblivious to the happenings all around you, you say you slept like a log. You do this specially when you are absolutely exhausted. Eats like a horse, sings like a bird, runs like the wind, has a memory like a sieve. Now what is a sieve? These are the pictures. For dry flour, you can sieve it, yes, on your left. But when you do, or when you try to separate some liquid or some solid, you know, semi-solid, then you can say you use strainers. Yes, so we use strainers to strain tea, to separate the tea and tea leaves. or you can even separate rice after boiling in this strainer on your right hand side. Yes? Now, so you can also have some more similes: as hard as iron, black as ebony, has a brain like a sieve, is as deaf as a post, like a log, was as cool as a cucumber. Try and use them and note the use of intensifiers. Yes, the hero never panicked in difficult situations. So you can say in extremely difficult situations. In the second one, instead of saying I might have been very tired, you can say I might have been totally exhausted. Yes, so this is how your intensifiers can make your writing better and it can embellish your writing. See the last one, my sister's hair is beautiful. So you can say my sister's hair is extremely beautiful. All right, now the next one, similes and metaphors. Now when you have similes and metaphors, in simile you use like or as. In metaphors you say she is a sleepy bear, the bread is a hard rock. You don't compare like or as. We don't use that, but we just compare it directly to the thing. Yes, her hair is a soft cloud. Not is like a cloud, but is soft cloud. In the same way, you have the other sentences as well. The dog is lightning fast. He is a blind bat. Not he is as blind as a bat. Yes, her eyelashes are a fluttering butterfly. Yes, her eyelashes are like a fluttering butterfly. See the difference? But both of them can embellish or make your writing beautiful. Learn these expressions in a metaphorical way, in a beautiful way. Yes, in this you can see he flew down the road. So you cannot fly, but see how he is describing, or it has been described, he flew. Yes, my sister has flaming red hair, the baby is the apple of my brother's eye. That means very precious, you can say. Yes, as Shakespeare said, all the world's a stage. So you need to learn a few lines from famous writers, poets, writings and compositions, all right, so that you can quote them wherever possible, proverbs, sayings, etc. Number 5, education is the escape hatch for many poor people. All right, what is escape hatch? The picture is below. It's an emergency exit. And see, all the world's a stage has been taken from the Seven Ages of Man, and it has been composed by William Shakespeare, and it has been quoted from the play As You Like It. All right, and we all know he's an undying brand in himself in the realm of English literature. All the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven ages. See how beautifully Shakespeare describes the seven stages or the ages in a man's life. All right, so we can learn a few lines here and there so that we can describe. Now we will do this, or this picture, in the next writing. That would be writing, or art of writing, part 3.